This helpless man you just saw on your screen was pleading to the Uttar Pradesh's chief medical officer for a letter that can perhaps save the life of his ailing mother, who was waiting to be admitted into a hospital for her coronavirus treatment. After this dramatic scene played out in full media and public view, this man finally got a letter from the UP CMO, but others are not so lucky. As India is reeling under a severe second wave of COVID-19, Uttar Pradesh, India's most populous state, is among the worst affected in the country. This even as authorities insist that the situation is under control. Now, adding to the woes of its people is a system of having a letter from the CMO for admission to an anti-COVID facility in UP. As per the UP's Health Minister Jai Pratap Singh, whenever a COVID-19 patient is registered with a command control center, a slip is made and the patient is either sent for home isolation or to a hospital for treatment. He justified the system by asking, if there is no signature of the official on the slip, then how will the payment be made to the hospitals? But even as the state is justifying such red tapism, cases and dead bodies are piling up in UP. With 34,000 fresh COVID-19 cases logged today itself, Uttar Pradesh witnessed its highest single day spike in new infections registered in the span of just 24 hours. Disturbing images of overcrowded testing centers, hospitals turning away patients, and funeral pyres burning round the clock at cremation grounds in UP's capital Lucknow and other major cities such as Varanasi, Kanpur, and Allahabad have made disturbing headlines across the nation. With over 240 million people, Uttar Pradesh is India's most populous state. Home to every sixth Indian, if it were a separate country, Uttar Pradesh would be the fifth largest by population in the world, just behind China, India, US and Indonesia. And of course, bigger than Pakistan and Brazil put together. UP is also politically the most important state of India. It sends the largest number of MPs, 80, to the parliament, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who, although from a different state, which is Gujarat, contests from UP. However, this political influence has brought in little development as per a BBC report. Among the sick are the state's Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, several of his cabinet colleagues, dozens of government officials, and hundreds of doctors, nurses, and other health workers. Over the past few days, grim stories of death and despair have been reported from across UP. Video shared by a local journalist in Kanpur show a sick man lying on the ground in the parking lot of the government-run Lala Lajpat Rai Hospital. A little distance away, an elderly man sits on a bench. They are both positive for COVID, but the hospital has no beds to accommodate them. Outside the government-run Kashiram Hospital, a young woman wept as she said that two hospitals had refused to admit her sick mother. They are saying they have run out of beds. If you don't have a bed, put her on the floor, but at least give her some treatment. There are lots of patients like her. I have seen several people like me being turned away. The Chief Minister says that there are adequate beds, but please show me where they are. Please treat my mother. This woman pleaded, sobbing inconsolably. The situation in the state capital Lucknow is also equally bad. Sushil Kumar Srivastava was photographed sitting in his car strapped to an oxygen cylinder while his desperate family drove him from one hospital to another. But by the time they found a bed for him, it was too late. Sushil Kumar had lost the battle to death. And it's not just commoners who are dying of apathy and lack of treatment. A retired judge, Ramesh Chandra's handwritten note in Hindi requesting help after the authorities failed to remove his wife's body from their home, was shared by hundreds of people on social media. In the note, he wrote, "My wife and I are both corona positive. Since yesterday morning, I called the government helpline numbers at least 50 times, but no one came to deliver any medicines or take us to the hospital." He blamed the administration's laxity for his wife's death that same morning. In UP's holy city of Varanasi, which is also PM Modi's constituency, long-time resident Vimal Kapoor described the situation as frightening. His 70-year-old mother Nirmala died due to COVID in a hospital last Thursday. He told the BBC, "I have seen too many people dying in ambulances. Hospitals are turning away patients because there are no beds. Chemists have run out of essential COVID drugs and oxygen is in short supply." Vimal Kapoor said that when he took his mother's body to the cremation ground, he encountered a Lashoka Dher. The cost of wood for the pyre has gone up 3 times and the waiting time for a spot for cremation has risen from about 15 minutes to 6 hours. Describing the horror, he said in Hindi, "Maine aisa khaufnak manzar aaj tak pehle kabhi nahi dekha. Jahan dekho, wahan sirf ambulance aur laashe." Critics have blamed the state and the union government for failing to anticipate the second wave. They say that there was a lull between September and February when the health services and infrastructure could have been improved. During this time, Uttar Pradesh could have created oxygen banks and also stocked up on medicines, but they squandered this opportunity. However, on his part, UP CM Yogi Adityanath has directed his officials to make oxygen concentrators available to districts from where the demands have come and sought support of the center also for its availability. CM Yogi termed the death of any person as unfortunate and directed the officials to give due honor to the aggrieved families and ensure that the cremations follow COVID-19 protocols. Noting that there is sufficient supply of medicine or oxygen, he said, "There is no shortage of tankers and cylinders, but keeping in mind the changing situation, additional tankers and cylinders should be arranged and it should be ensured that there is no black marketing of oxygen and other medicines." He also directed officials to ensure transparency in allotment of beds in hospitals and asked them to arrange transport facilities for migrant laborers and also to ensure that they are kept in quarantine centers for at least 7 days. The UP CM has announced that the vaccine will be available free of cost for people above 18 from 1st of May. But despite these assurances and directions, deaths continue to mount in UP, which is under a night curfew and weekend lockdown until at least 15th of May. Please let me know your thoughts by commenting below. And if you are from UP, please share your experience and the ground reality from the state in the comment section below so that all of us get the information firsthand. We can connect on my Instagram as well. It's @ReviewRon. Subscribe here if you find my videos worth it. But even if you don't, thank you so much for watching. And please take care of yourself and those around you. Stay safe. Jai Hind.